Hey everybody, welcome to Bura Tech. In this episode, we're going to be asking the question, should Apple release its own game console? Alright, so if you like Bura Tech, make sure that you like and subscribe. And today's featured course is Hello Coding. Get 170 hours of content for a discounted price below. Remember that every single dollar that we get from the courses that you purchase below, we put into making more content. So if you don't already know, Apple makes a ton of money with its App Store, not only just the Mac App Store for its macOS ecosystem, but mostly its iOS App Store. Companies make millions to hundreds of millions to even billions of dollars on this App Store. Now, Apple has an Apple TV, but the gaming situation on Apple TV isn't very good. Should Apple make Apple TV more of a gaming console? So why hasn't Apple done this? Apple is one of the most valuable companies in the world, and oftentimes it trades places with another tech company like Microsoft. So because of this, they know what they're doing, and Apple specifically doesn't enter a market unless they think they can dominate. So Apple TV could become a game console, but the real question is why haven't they done it? The short answer is money. They need a lot of money to hire the right people and make sure that Apple TV as a game console would be successful. Personally, I think that if Apple TV were to become a game console, it would be wildly successful. Here are my five reasons from a developer's point of view on why I want Apple to make an Apple TV game console. First, the App Store review process is really good. Now, if you're an Android person and you like uploading to Google Play, you'll understand that Apple is a little bit more in depth. But personally, I think the app review process is quite fair. In addition, uploading to Apple is a lot better than uploading a game to any of the other consoles. The reason for this is history. To make a console game, it usually took a lot of big dollars. And not only did it take a lot of big dollars, but it took a lot of hardware as well. In fact, if you wanted to make a console game in the past, you had to buy a dev kit. And these dev kits cost a lot of money, so it was very prohibitive to actually make a console game. With Apple, the app review process is really awesome, and you can just simply make your game. My second point is that Apple already has the ecosystem to make Apple TV games good. The reason is that if you pull up Xcode, you can make a project that spans from your iPhone to your iPad to your macOS to your Apple TV. It's all done in one project. Furthermore, engines like Unity and Unreal will allow you to publish for Apple TV with simply a click of a button, and this is really awesome. In fact, this is so awesome that if you are an old developer like me, you'll realize how amazing it is. In the past, this was really challenging to do, and porting a game from system to system took a lot of time. Now, it's just simply a click of a button. Of course, there's more work that needs to be done, like setting up the game controller code, but it's way easier today than it was in the past. The third reason is that couch co-op is making a comeback. Remember playing games with your friend in the same room? Nowadays, multiplayer is done with strangers all across the world. Personally, I like this, but I have fond memories of playing with my friends in the same room. You know, we could be eating pizza, drinking pop, and having a great time. Now that people that remember this are getting older and having kids, parents want to play games with their kids, and I have a couple kids, and I would love to play games with kids as well. It would be great to have a fun family experience playing in the same room together. Imagine the experiences you can have with a great system. Because developing for the console system is so convoluted, if Apple TV made a game console and made couch co-op a priority, I'm sure it would be successful. Developers would flock to this chance if Apple promoted it. The fourth reason is that there's a lot of Apple TVs out there, and there's a lot of people used to playing on the Apple ecosystem. This seems like a natural progression that Apple could do. In fact, they can even charge a little bit more money than their iOS devices. You can play your game on your phone, on your iPad, on your Mac, or on your Apple TV. It would be one game that you could go between devices. The last reason is that I love playing games on a big HD screen. Now, I love playing the iPhone game in the airport, or for example, playing an iPad game on an airplane, but I absolutely love just sitting in a nice chair playing a really good game in front of a big screen. This is one of my favorite things to do, and it would be awesome if I could maybe play a game on a plane and then come back and play the rest of the game in front of a big screen TV. While Apple does have somewhat of an ecosystem for games, I think the potential is huge, and Apple would be unwise to not tap that potential. Now that I've talked about why I think Apple TV would be a great success, here are some suggestions to Apple specifically to make Apple TV amazing. So Apple, if you are gonna make a games console, make your own custom controller. Just like Xbox or PlayStation, you need to have a really good controller that feels great to play on. I'm not talking about a third-party add-on, I'm talking about a really nice controller. Apple's known for quality, and this can be no exception. If you're gonna make a game console, please make it easy to make couch co-op games. Sometimes it's really difficult from the code level to add in different controllers and different player slots, and it can be way more confusing than you expect it to be. For example, if one controller disconnects, then there's a whole bunch of things that can happen in the game. You want to make sure that on the code level that this is really easy to handle. In fact, if you go back 10 or 15 years, some big development studios had a whole team that dealt with controller disconnects. Their whole job was to deal with how the game reacts when the controller disconnects. You want to make this really easy for the developer. Apple, if you're going to make a game console, make sure you get great third-party content. I want to be able to play Overwatch on my Apple TV, and I want to be able to play some Nintendo games, if Nintendo will allow you. Another thing that would be amazing to have on the Apple TV is nostalgic games. These are retro games. And these are games like the NES, the SNES, or the N64. I want to be able to purchase these games and maybe even play some of these games with my kids. It would be amazing to have a vast library of these games for purchase on the App Store. Remember, nostalgia is key. And last but not least, this is something that I really, really want Apple to do. In fact, I can make my own video about this, and I might even just do that. But please make web views available on the Apple TV. I want to be able to make a game in Construct 3 and then upload it to Apple TV. I don't see a very good reason on why this should be disallowed, but you cannot make an HTML5 and put it onto an Apple TV. If you really don't want web views, you need to find some kind of framework that will allow HTML5 games to be played on the Apple TV. This is my biggest personal gripe with developing for tvOS. I want to be able to make a game in Construct 3 and then upload it to tvOS, and right now there's no way to do that. Perhaps you could even talk to the folks at Cordova to develop a specific framework for this to happen. Alright, thanks for listening. So that wraps up this video. I think Apple TV could make an amazing game console if Apple wanted it to be. Now, if you like this video, make sure that you like and subscribe and check out our course, Hello Coding. Get 170 hours of content for a discounted price below. Remember that every single dollar that we make from the courses that you buy below, we put into making more content. Thanks again, and I'll see you in another video.